Apparently, Ivanka Trump wants to be the first female president of the United States.
That's not going to happen.
No?
No. Mm-mm.
How come?
Well, we don't want any more inexperienced Trumps in the White House.
I think that normally I would like to believe what you're saying, but I've also learned after these elections that things that we didn't expect to happen sometimes do happen.
Well, that's true, but, you know, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. And I think the American people have seen for themselves what happens when a reality TV candidate wins. Mm-hmm. And I really believe there's an enormous amount of pent-up energy to take our country back away from the Trump administration. And I believe we've got a very good chance of winning the House of Representatives, which will begin the process of righting the ship of state.
In this last election, the nation was assaulted by imposters masquerading as reporters.
If you don't read the newspaper, you're uninformed. If you do read it, you're misinformed.
It's illegal to possess these stolen documents.
For 25 years, and I was educated to lie, to betray.
What CNN is doing is they're essentially creating infomercials for dictators.
During her recent visit to India, Hillary Clinton suffered yet another mishap when a fall in the resort in which she was staying left the former Secretary of State in constant pain. Doctors were called to the Umaid Bawan Palace on Tuesday after Clinton fractured her wrist by slipping in a bathtub at the five-star resort. The fall forced the 70-year-old public figure to cancel her plans to the 15th century Mehranga Fort that evening. Instead, she was escorted to a hospital in the city of Jodhpur around 5 in the morning the next day. After undergoing both a CT scan and an X-ray, doctors confirmed Clinton had a hairline fracture in her right wrist. She was promptly given a plaster bandage and told to have it checked in 3 days. Shortly afterwards, Clinton was seen covering the injury with a Navy shawl. She canceled the other scheduled visits throughout Jodhpur before catching a private jet to Jaipur. The Times of India reported that Clinton has been receiving ongoing pain treatment ever since her arrival on Tuesday. The former Secretary of State was also seen slipping on multiple stairs during a portion of her visit at the Jahaz Mahal in the ancient city of Mandu, which reports noting that Clinton had used her right hand to brace herself. It's unclear whether it was this fall or another one later that was the source of her injury. Clinton's physical injuries were not the only thing that caught the public's attention, as she, once again, stirred controversy with her comments regarding her loss in the 2016 presidential election. Speaking at a conference in Mumbai over the weekend, the presidential hopeful suggested both racism and misogyny were the perpetrators that caused her loss to Donald Trump. Clinton told those in attendance, quote, "I won the places that represent two-thirds of America's gross domestic product, so I won the places that are optimistic, diverse, dynamic, moving forward." The former Secretary of State suggested that Trump's Make America Great Again campaign was essentially, quote, "looking backwards," and that the current administration didn't want minorities to receive further rights. Quote, "You know you didn't like black people getting rights. You don't like women, you know, getting jobs," she added, claiming that the majority of married white women voted for Trump due to, quote, "ongoing pressure to vote the way that your husband, your boss, your son, whoever believes you should." For WesternJournal.com, I'm Stephen Beyer.
John Dunn.
Subscribe now.
I really believe there's an enormous amount of pent-up energy to take our country back away from the Trump administration. And I believe we've got a very good chance of winning the House of Representatives, which will begin the process of righting the ship of state.
In this last election, the nation was assaulted by imposters masquerading as reporters.
If you don't read the newspaper, you're uninformed. If you do read it...
Apparently, Ivanka Trump wants to be the first female president of the United States.
That's not going to happen.
No?
No.
Mm-mm. How come?
Well, we don't want any more inexperienced Trumps in the White House.
I think that normally I would like to believe what you're saying, but I've also learned after these elections that things that we didn't expect to happen sometimes do happen.
Well, that's true, but, you know, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. And I think the American people have seen for themselves what happens when a reality TV candidate wins. Mm-hmm. And I really...
You're misinformed.
It's illegal to possess these stolen documents.
For 25 years, and I was educated to lie, to betray.
What CNN is doing is they're essentially creating infomercials for dictators.
During her recent visit to India, Hillary Clinton suffered yet another mishap when a fall in the resort in which she was staying left the former Secretary of State in constant pain. Doctors were called to the Umaid Bawan Palace on Tuesday after Clinton fractured her wrist by slipping in a bathtub at the five-star resort. The fall forced the 70-year-old public figure to cancel her plans to the 15th century Mehuranga Fort that evening. Instead, she was escorted to a hospital in the city of Jodhpur around 5 in the morning the next day. After undergoing both a CT scan and an X-ray, doctors confirmed Clinton had a hairline fracture in her right wrist. She was promptly given a plaster bandage and told to have it checked in 3 days. Shortly afterwards, Clinton was seen covering the injury with a Navy Shaw. She canceled the other scheduled visits throughout Jodhpur before catching a private jet to Jaipur. The Times of India reported that Clinton has been receiving ongoing pain treatment ever since her arrival on Tuesday. The former Secretary of State was also seen slipping on multiple stairs during a portion of her visit at the Jahaz Mahal in the ancient city of Mandu, which reports noting that Clinton had used her right hand to brace herself. It's unclear whether it was this fall or another one later that was the source of her injury. Clinton's physical injuries were not the only thing that caught the public's attention, as she, once again, stirred controversy with her comments regarding her loss.